Amen. Bwana Yesu asifiwe.
Amen.
Bwana Yesu asifiwe.
Amen.
We should be assured that what we've placed ourselves in is going to last forever. Amen? Amen? Well, perhaps you've heard so many times, we've been told things like, or you've read somewhere that faith unlocks the heaven's gate, or faith is the key to heaven. We've heard that, right? Yes, without faith it is impossible to please God. We all need faith to please God. Amen? Yes. One time I was seated somewhere in school and a thought just came to me that it's like faith, it's the medium on which God moves on. Where you stretch your faith, that's where God is going to reach. If you stretch your faith from here up to where Mike is and God's promises are up to where Asha Nathan is standing, if your faith is up to Mike, it will just go up to that point, because from there, God cannot walk with you because you do not have faith. Praise God. Praise God. So there is need for us to stretch our faith. It's going to be tough. Yes, some of us have been stretched. It will cost most of us to move from our comfort zones, to forgo the things that we held so dearly. Yes, but it's worth it. Praise God. A person without faith, a person with faith, however little it is, they can do wondrous things. For example, we've heard of the story of the woman who had the issue of blood. For 12 years, she had visited all the physicians that she could think of, spent so much money just to get her issue dealt with. But it was all in vain. Nothing happened. But one good day, she heard that the Lord, the Master, the King of Kings, was to move in that town. And so with the little faith that she had, she said to herself, probably if I just go and touch the hem of his cloak, I will be healed. She went there with some hope, with an expectation, an assurance that if she touches the cloak of Jesus, then all will be well. And wasn't that so? Wasn't that so? Yes. Immediately the Bible says that the issue stopped. Immediately. It is all because God saw the faith in the woman that he administered. The heavens came for this woman. Praise God. It is they with childlike faith that get to enter the rest. Let's all open the book of Matthew. Matthew chapter 18. Matthew chapter 18. I will be reading from the NIV version. Chapter 18 from verse 1. And it says, at that time, the disciples came to Jesus and asked, who then is the greatest in the kingdom of heaven? He called a little child to him and placed the child among them. And he said, truly, I tell you, unless you change and become like little children, you will never enter the kingdom of heaven. Therefore, whoever takes the lowly position of this child is the greatest in the kingdom of heaven. And whoever welcomes one such child in my name welcomes me. Praise God. It is they with childlike faith will enter the rest. The rest that God provided for us from the very beginning. The rest that God promised Noah, and only those who believed got into that rest. The rest that we are all waiting for, the end of age, waiting for our King Jesus to come back for us. That rest that lasts forever. That is the rest that God is talking about. Praise God. Even here on earth, we've been given slices of eternity, right? And praise God, we are in one of those churches whereby we get to experience this good thing that the Lord brings for us. Praise God. Yes. So it is they who believe enter into that rest. This year we were given a wonderful theme, a powerful theme. And probably because somewhere along the way doubt came in or things in our life came in, it caused us to doubt. And because of doubt, we were not able to do an exploit in a given area. It could be your finances. It could be in overcoming a given struggle. Praise God. Yeah, because of doubts, we're not able to be strong and do exploits in the name of the Lord. So without rest, without faith, it is impossible to enter into that rest that the Lord has promised, long gone promised. Praise God. Praise God. Well, because of his act of faith, Abraham, the one we sing of in Sunday school, Father Abraham had many sons. That Father Abraham enjoyed a gift of a son. Because of faith, he believed and he leapt in faith. And thereafter, he got a son. Thereafter, a covenant was established with him. And up to date, we are still partakers of that covenant. Praise God. There is a continual of his name. We have never forgotten Father Abraham. We still sing of him. Praise God. Because of his childlike faith, Gideon, from the smallest tribe of Manasseh, was able to conquer the enemies of the Israelites. He believed when the angel of the Lord appeared to him, and he conquered. Praise God. Even with very few soldiers, 300 of them, he was able to slay thousands and thousands of their enemies. Praise God. 2018 has been a great year, as I mentioned earlier on. A strong conviction in my heart is that if amongst us we exercise that faith that I'm talking about, we have been able to experience explosion in given phases of our life. Praise God. It could be in your finances, relationship, family, ministry, all these things, they require faith. Because you say that faith is the medium which God uses to come and administer to us. And as he comes, he does not come empty-handed. He comes with benefits. He comes with gifts. Praise God. He comes with victories. He has conquered for us so much this year. And as Faith was praying, she mentioned that, yes, he has delivered us from the hand of the enemy. So we ought to praise him because he came in our situation. And now today we are standing here. We can lift up our hands and praise him. Praise his name because he did something wonderful. Just because of faith. The little faith, the mustard kind of faith. Praise God. The ultimatum of our salvation is entering the rest, the one that the Lord has promised. When you read Matthew 2, it says, he called a little child to him and placed the child among them. And then he said what he said in the next verse in chapter 3, in verse 3. Okay? While I was preparing for this, I should say I was privileged because last week was an awesome time for me. I enjoyed myself, playing around with children, being with them, and also throughout the year I've been with children in the children ministry, both at school and here. And even this week, I had an opportunity to spend time with my nephew. So while I was still thinking on this, on the word of God, I could see these points, like they could click in my mind. I could see what the Lord was trying to mean when he said childlike faith. Praise God. Jesus, well, after Solomon, Jesus and Solomon was the wisest of is and was the wisest of them all. He used simple things, activities, things that we take for granted in our daily lives, to bring out a heavenly concept so that we may be able to understand what he tries to mean. And in this case, we see Jesus using the children to bring out the point of humility, generosity, all these things, so that we may be able to grasp the concept of heaven, so that we may not be able to miss heaven. Praise God. Throughout his ministry, he used activities. He called out fishermen. And sometimes he would use the same activities to help them understand. He told them that he's going to make them to be fishers of men. Okay? Probably if you could have used another term, like in accounting, they could not understand. But because they were fishermen, they understood very well that when you go to the sea, you have to cast out your nets, and after a while, pull out, and you have such a great harvest. For them, they understood when they said fishers of men, they understood precisely what's supposed to be done. Praise God. As you continue, I'd like you to be thinking of the children who are in your life, probably your parents. Think of your children. You're in the ministry, think of your children. And try to see those little things that they do that once you see them, you're like, oh, look at that. Or you're just moved by that tiny thing that they are doing as you continue the sermon, okay? Okay. Let's open Luke chapter 18. Luke chapter 18 from verse 15 to 17. It's still the same, but how this account brings out something else that was not brought out in Matthew. And I'd like us to look it over. Luke chapter 18 from verse 15, yes, to 17. Are we there? If you're there, say amen. Oh, okay. And it says, people were also bringing babies to Jesus for him to place his hands on them. When the disciples saw this, they rebuked them. But Jesus called the children to him and said, let the little children come to me, and do not hinder them from the kingdom of God, for the kingdom of God belongs to such as this. Truly, I tell you, anyone who will not receive the kingdom of God like little children will never enter it. My emphasis is on verse 17 that says, anyone who does not receive the kingdom of God like a little child will never enter it. I can take you back through in my memory. I remember the first time I heard about heaven and it was explained to me, it was by my brother, my big brother. He brought me one of these books. I actually know that I still have it. And as I used to read it over, I came to a page where I could see like the world drawn and then children. And then it said that they are going to go to heaven someday and be with the king forever. So I did not understand exactly. But the way my brother explained it made me curious. I wanted to go to heaven. I wanted to meet Jesus. Okay? So I had this orange dress. It was those leather that has tears. And then I had some other purple socks that had like a flower somewhere. So I used to like matching those two. And so in my mind, I purposed, when I was little, I purposed, like Daniel, I purposed that this dress, I think I'll wear it when Jesus comes because I want to look my best. Because for me, that was my best, okay? So every time my sister used to, well, once I've showered, and then she wants to put me on the, I used to sometimes rebel because I know it's for a special occasion. I was so curious, I wanted to go to heaven, okay? But as I continued growing up, my childlike faith was diluted. I got into the world, into things that I'm not proud of, but I'm glad that Jesus delivered me. Amen? I'm glad that he delivered me, but today I can stand here and say that Jesus redeemed my life. Praise God. Yes, I was curious as a little one. Okay? So this is one of the things that we need to be curious. We need to be curious about the kingdom of heaven. The good curiosity. Okay? Yes. So, we've been in one or another had the opportunity to interact with children. Let me speak for myself. I have had that opportunity to speak to interact with children. And when I'm around them, I feel so happy. I feel so elated because I like their genuineness, how they come to you and ask you questions sometimes. Others are very tough. You can't answer because you're afraid you'll be introducing a new concept to them and they will be like, so now, since you've said this, so now what is this? And then at the end of the day, you'll have answered over 50 questions. Okay? But it's a good experience. Children are like that. Okay? Children have, if I may say, like two sides. There's that one side a parent would always want the child to have. When visitors come, they know that probably so-and-so will go, greet the visitor, ask them, hi, what can I offer you? Can I give you a glass of juice? Such kind. And then there's the other side that parents are always very keen. And then as they say in African moms, they just give you an eye. And that's just you'll be disciplined. Okay? There's also that other side. Are you together? Well, I know we've all seen both of these sides, but I'd like us to go into that other side that we all owe about all the time, we see and we admire. Are you together? When Jesus looked at the children, the disciples were busy chasing away the children from Jesus because probably they had in mind that a child, when they come to a grown-up, they want to be happy all the time. You lift them up, raise them up, or tickle them so they can laugh, you know, all those things, or ask questions. And their master was busy. He was busy sharing the message about the kingdom. So the disciples rebuked the children away from him. But Jesus, being who he is, such a gentleman, he said, no, bring the children to me. Because he saw something in the children. Praise God. He saw something in them. So I was able to compile a few things. And also for you, I pray that as you continue breaking this bread, that the Holy Spirit will help you understand some other things, probably that you have muted in your life, that you may be able to imitate from the children and take it on as you go to 2019. Praise God. So when Jesus looked at the children, I believe the first thing he saw and he always sees in children is humility. How many have seen a humble child? How many of us have seen a humble child? Good. I have a good number. My the definition of humility was not seeing yourself to be low, but lowly thinking of yourself. Let me repeat that. Not seeing yourself to be low, but lowly thinking about yourself. Jesus saw us first. He saw that if he doesn't die for us, then we'll forever be in pain in the fires of hell. So he saw us first. He was humble enough to leave all the riches, all the glory in heaven and come to us as a baby and grow up in stature until the point where he's going to take away our sins. Praise God. Praise God. He was humble. He saw us. Then he came and died for us. Okay? He saw the humility in the children. This is something that all of us as Christians need to ask God to help us understand what it means to be humble. It is not something that you always speak about, no. It stems from your heart. It flows from within to without. Are you together? Yes, it flows from within and comes out naturally. We ask God that you may help us to be humble, just like the children. Praise God. The kingdom of heaven is for the humble in spirit. God, throughout the scriptures, you've seen how he resists the proud. He resists them. And in Proverbs, it even goes on ahead to tell us that pride is followed by disgrace. You take a look in this phase of life up to where you've reached and try to spot a proud person that you've seen. You will definitely tell me that afterwards there was disgrace. Disgrace followed. But for a person who is humble, humility comes with wisdom. Praise God. Humility comes with wisdom. We can look at Jesus, for example. He was humble. He was all powerful. At a snap, he could cause everyone here to turn into dust. But he was humble because he's powerful. But he was humble enough and could mingle with us, the sinners, just to point them to the right direction. Okay? Hebrews 1:5 flows with boastful words from the Father to the Son, speaking of how he was able to conquer all that he had been sent to do. Praise God. And the Father speaks highly of him, and even we see how he speaks. He said that his name shall be greater than all the other names on earth. Why do you think it's so? Because a humble person at all times, if you look in our lives, they always receive praise. Okay? And I pray that, as for me as well, if I when I continue being humble, that when those praises come, I will not forget who I am and start showing off that, yes, I'm this person. No, I pray that as I continue walking in this journey of humility, journey of faith, being humble, that every time praises come, yes, I will feel happy, but I would like people to point to God because he's the one who has made it in me. Praise God. At the end of the day, what you do should be pointing back to God. Okay? The second thing is, after humility, he saw one who openly asks. Praise God. Since I began serving in the ministry, children ministry, and also where I've done my internships and volunteering, I think I've answered so many questions from children that I can't keep record. Some of them, they will repeat. Like my nephew this week, I think he has called my name auntie so many times until it just keeps ringing in my head, because every time he uttered the word auntie, he had a question. Like, auntie, umakula food? Auntie, unaenda wapi? All those questions. I had to answer all these questions. Children ask openly. They do not hide. They are not afraid. Praise God. Because, you know, children now, when they come, they have come into a new world and they like to understand what is happening in this world that they have stepped into. Okay? Sometime last year, I had a discussion with a friend and we were discussing on childlikeness. I stumbled upon the verse on Matthew and I was struck. I wanted to understand exactly what Jesus saw. And so we began this discussion. And as we continued, he continued pointing out something very profound that I would like to quote. And he said that the most childlike in his presence is the most mature. Praise God. Let me repeat that. The most childlike in his presence is the most mature. This rang in my head for a while because at that time, I think I was thinking of the word childish, not childlike. But now when you start seeing these qualities, the traits that are endowed by children, you'll begin to understand what it means being childlike. And when you're childlike in his presence, then at the end of the day, you become mature. Praise God. Praise God. John the Beloved for sure understood what being childlike means. And that's why you'll find him so close to Jesus, because he really wanted to learn so much, and probably with his openness, with his genuine heart, he will go on forth, keep striking, asking Jesus questions to understand about the kingdom of heaven. He understood this quality for sure. Praise God. The woman who came with an alabaster jar with oil. This was one of the things that came up in our discussion. And we could see that this woman, despite all those people who were around her, she did not care about her reputation. No. Instead, she went forth and anointed the feet of Jesus with the perfume, tears, and drying with her hair. She went forth. But for the disciples, like Akira Judas, they were seeing how much money has been wasted. They could have sold that and given it to the poor. But this woman, I think she understood. She understood the whole thing of asking openly. Praise God. And because of that, Jesus went on and stated that she'll never be forgotten. And for sure, we are still talking about her right now. Praise God. Yeah. From the beginning, we've established that we are children. And as we continue as children, I'd like us to ask the Father to help us to be childlike. Let us be childlike in our faith. If we are childlike, we'll ride on to all the things that the Lord is going to give us, even beginning next year. We are still 8 days away from the year to end, and a lot can happen if we just embrace a childlike posture. Praise God. At times, we may not understand the things that happen or the things that the Lord calls us to do. Yes? Abraham did not understand when the Lord told him to leave his motherland, to go to somewhere he doesn't know. He didn't understand. But because of faith and reverence, he decided, yes, I'm going to walk and go with the Lord. And you can all see what came forth after obedience. Praise God. As life gets tough, we become toughened. That's true. But that does not mean we also toughen our vulnerability before God. Praise God. This has to remain. We need to remain children and keep crying on to Jesus. Okay? Keep crying on to Jesus because he knows us. He knows us. Praise God. He knows us. Praise God. Okay. Children are honest. Praise God. They are known for their sharp and point blank questions. They will ask to understand. And most of the time, their ulterior motive is to understand the truth behind what they have seen. Isn't it not right? Yes. They will understand the truth that they have. They want to pursue. Praise God. So, how many times have we gone before the Lord and stripped ourselves of all our worries just to be able to enjoy the rest that he has brought for us? How many times? How many times? That's something we all need to ponder on, okay? I remember a while ago when it came to my time of praying, and I was going through a struggle in my life, and I did not know how to, because afterwards I would feel so filthy. I would fidget, I would start masquerading my prayer, sugarcoat it, in a way that will help me not think that I have said it before God. And at one point, I had a meeting with Bishop and Mom, and they helped me understand that I have to call it by name. Praise God. I have to call what it is by name and ask him to deliver me from it. Praise God. It took me so back that most of the times I would quit in so many things. Sorry. It took me so back that at times I would lie of my current state of faith. It took me so back that it made me stagnate in my walk of faith. But I thank God, because of faith, he called me into this faith. I leaped into the light. And as faith has said, he made it possible for me to overcome it. And today I can stand here and say that I am a victor. Praise God. Praise God. This God that we serve, it might be hard to understand. I can tell you for sure from my life. At times when people would say in church that he will help you, I could not see how he can help me. I have tried, I've even made covenants with myself, I have said I will never. And then months or just weeks or even sometimes worse still hours, I find myself in the same state again. It was so draining. Even at times I would get so mad, and let me just say, I would even not speak with respect to my parents because I know what I was going through. But I'm glad because of faith, someone spoke faith to me. Faith comes by hearing and hearing the word of God. Praise God. People kept speaking to me about faith. I shared with people and they did not help me. They would just come and ask me, but they did not pray for me. But because someone spoke to me, the true faith, I believed. And now today I stand here saying that I am a victor. Praise God. Yes, this is what faith does to us. Step into the waters and you will see a path will be made for you. Praise God. Yeah. Children, after humility, the one who openly asks and being honest, children do not know what's best for them. Praise God. They don't know what's best for them. We are children. Our God is an all-knowing God. He's omniscient, right? And since we are children, we were not here before with him when he was spanning everything into existence. He was there, so he knows. So despite all the PhDs that you might have, all the degrees you might hold, at the end of the day, we need to be vulnerable and go back to God because he knows exactly what you all need. Praise God. We need to go back to him and ask him the way forth. Okay? Yes. Search his word. Listen to his heart. Listen to the ordained minister that he has given us to get to know what we are supposed to do because we are children. Children grow. And as they grow, I know it is to the very best interest of every parent here. And even for those who are expelled, when they get a baby, that baby will have to grow into the ways of the Lord. Okay? They will grow into the ways of the Lord. Praise God. I know many times when probably a child comes from here and goes to where Fabrice is seated at the system and they try to play with the buttons, Fabrice will run to go and stop them because what they are doing is something that is very wrong, okay? And they might end up destroying it. So they go and bar them from doing that. The Lord does this to us as well. He knows what is right. He guides our steps. So if you go to him and ask him for the right direction in a childlike faith, despite our status in the society, then at the end of the day, it's going to be best fit for us all, and we are going to be safe and sound. Praise God. As I conclude, it is childlike faith that David had before he went to attack an army of their enemies. He went back to God and asked him for a direction. That's childlike faith. It is childlike faith if we all sought out to ask God to help us to walk into the theme that he gives us every year. Even this theme here, we walk with him. It is childlike. Even for 2019, it is my prayer that I will walk in a childlike faith, that I'll be able to conquer all that the Lord has in store for each and every one of us, so that even as I continue, all the benefits will come. Praise God. I'm convinced that if a father who is a military man and has a child in a school and they know whom this child belongs to, at the end of the day, they will not even think of bullying that child because they know that if they do and the father gets to know of it, they'll be in big trouble. Instead, they'll want to befriend the child and even probably go to their homes because they understand. So, do we know our father? Do we know our father? That's a rhetorical question. May God help us all. May he help me to have a childlike faith that as I step out into the space of next year that God will have given me, I will walk in it in childlike faith. and experience all the good things that the Lord has in store for me. And I pray that this too shall be the prayer for each and every one of us. As we usher in 2019, it shall be a year whereby we'll walk like a child before our Lord. Amen? Yes. Thank you. And Merry Christmas, everyone.